Welcome to Bible Tract Echoes. This program is the radio ministry of Bible Tracts Incorporated. Our mission is to take the Word of God to all the world. Our Bible teacher is the director of Bible Tracts, Pastor Mark Smith. Since 1938, Bible Tracts Incorporated has been publishing clear gospel tracts and supplying them to churches, missionaries, and individuals all over the world, and all at no charge. Information on how you can receive a free sample pack of our tracts will be given at the end of this broadcast. Now for our Bible study, here is our teacher, Pastor Mark Smith.
How do you do, my friend? Welcome to the broadcast. I am so delighted you're here. Thanks so much for joining us. My Bible is sitting open to the book of Leviticus, chapter 1. And it may seem strange to you, but I'm excited about teaching Leviticus, chapter 1. Now, please don't get turned off because I mentioned the word Leviticus. It's a book of the Bible. It's inspired of God. And my dear listener friend, I think you're going to enjoy what we find in Leviticus. Chapter 1. You may just end up liking the book of Leviticus. So right now, if you can, get your Bible open with me to Leviticus chapter 1. Get something with which you can jot some notes down. I got four words beginning with a letter B, but also with that paper, you can jot down how to contact us because I want to put some gospel tracts into your hand. But let me lead into Leviticus 1 this way. And by the way, my title for this particular chapter is this: How can I save my skin? Now, here's a question for you right now, though. How can a sinful believer ever approach a holy God to rightly worship him? Now, actually, that's a question you and I need to be asking ourselves and answering each and every day. Now, the answer won't change from day to day, but there's an attitude of being haphazard in worshiping God that so easily pops up in our lives day by day. On Monday this week, I did a very brief introduction to the study of the book of Leviticus. It is the most unread book of the Bible by the people who follow Jesus Christ as Savior. But I want to begin today with a study that will take a look at chapter 1, or actually one chapter per broadcast. At least that's going to be the normal approach. The one question I keep asking myself in doing the preparation for this is, why does a believer who wants to share the gospel of Jesus Christ with a lost person, why do they need this chapter out of Leviticus? So right now, get your Bible and join me at Leviticus 1, and let's find out some answers. A moment ago, I mentioned gospel tracts. That word tracts is spelled T-R-A-C-T-S. We're talking about a short written presentation of the gospel of Jesus Christ. We've been publishing gospel tracts for over 80 years, and this is actually our 80th year of doing this. We give them away all over the world. I want to put a sample packet of our gospel tracts into your hand. At the end of the broadcast, my announcer will tell you how that can happen, so have that pen and paper ready, or you can just jot down our website. I'll give it to you right now. Our web address is the name of our ministry, BibleTractsInc.org. BibleTractsInc.org. The gospel tract in my hand right now is entitled, I'm Keeping the Golden Rule. You want to hear a funny story? You know what the golden rule is, right? Do unto others as you would have them do unto you. I was out to a restaurant here a couple of weeks ago with my wife. I put the tip down with this track, I'm Keeping the Golden Rule. We paid our bill, we're walking out, and all of a sudden, the waiter is running after us trying to give me my tip back. Believe it or not, he's trying to give me my tip back. I looked rather funny at him saying, what are you doing? He said, well, I'm trying to keep the golden rule, like the paper you put down said. And I laughed. I said, oh, you didn't read the piece of paper, did you? He said, no. I said, you keep the tip, then read the paper when you get off work, and it'll tell you why I want you to have this money and why the golden rule has some flaws in it. He looked at me rather funny. You see, so many people think by keeping the golden rule, they'll be able to get into heaven. That's not why it was given, friend. this gospel tract will explain it. It's a great soul-winning tool, great evangelism tool. Get it from us. It's in that sample packet. Be ready when my announcer gives our contact information. If you have your Bible open to Leviticus 1, look at verse 1, chapter 1 says this, "And the Lord called unto Moses, and spake unto him out of the tabernacle of the congregation, saying, Speak unto the children of Israel, and say unto them, If any man of you bring an offering unto the Lord, he shall bring your offering of the cattle, even of the herd, and of the flock. If his offering be a burnt sacrifice of the herd, let him offer a male without blemish. He shall offer it of his own voluntary will at the door of the tabernacle of the congregation before the Lord. And he, that is the worshiper, shall put his hand upon the head of the burnt offering, and it shall be accepted for him to make atonement for him. And he shall kill, that is the offer shall kill the bullock," verse 5 begins. Verse 6 says, "He shall flay, the offer shall flay or skin the burnt offering." Now jump down to verse 9. "But his inwards, the animal's inwards, and his legs shall he wash in water." The worshiper is going to wash the internal parts of the sacrifice. Now, listen, friend, the book of Leviticus is a book on worship. It was not for the Gentile nations. It was a book directed to God's people, the Jews, in how to properly worship him. If you are a note taker, then jot down these differences between the book of Exodus that just precedes it and the book of Leviticus, these three key things. Exodus begins with enslaved sinners, but Leviticus begins with redeemed saints. Number two, in Exodus, God gets his people out of Egypt, but in Leviticus, God's trying to get Egypt out of his people. Then in Exodus, God speaks from Mount Sinai and God comes down to men. But in Leviticus, God speaks from the tent, the tabernacle, which is among the people, and men are learning to come to God. Those are key differences. Now, chapters 1 through 7 are all about how the Jews were to approach God. These first seven chapters give us a group of sacrifices. The chapter 1 is all about what's called the burnt offering, the burnt sacrifice. In chapter 1, there are two key people in view. First of all, the individual Jewish person bringing the offering, and secondly, there's a priest. To begin to worship God, an individual must be right with God. Now, that's what the burnt offering was all about. This offering was not one to help a sinner get saved. The burnt offering is about how a person who is already belongs to God can be fit to come into the presence of God and worship him. It's going to make, at the end of verse 4, an atonement for the sins between the last time he there and dealt with God. Let me quickly give you four key features of the burnt offering, and in doing so, I'm going to use four words all beginning with the letter B, like in the word baseball. Ready? Number one, bring. Bring. The Jewish worshiper must bring a proper sacrifice. That's verses 3 and 4. Second B word is break. Break. The worshiper had to personally kill the sacrificed animal. That's verse 5. Third word is the word blood. Based upon verse 5, the priest had to sprinkle the blood before the altar. And then word number four is the word burn. As found in verse 9, the priest must then burn almost the entire sacrifice. Now, please notice I said almost all the sacrifice was burnt. Not all, almost. In verse 6, we are told that the one bringing the sacrifice had to flay or had to skin the animal. The only thing not burned by the fire was going to be the skin. Do you know why? Oh, you see, you and I go to God in worship to do a couple of things. Number one, obviously to honor and adore him. That's part of worship. But number two, we go to worship there to know God better and to become more like him. Are you familiar with Galatians 2:20? We find in that verse, Galatians 2:20, these words, I am crucified with Christ, and nevertheless I live. Yet not I, but Christ liveth in me, and the life which I now live in the flesh, the skin, the life which I now live in the flesh, I live by the faith of the Son of God who loved me and gave himself for me. Now, friend, you and I, if we're believers, we go to God in worship to remind ourselves that we are dead to ourselves and alive unto Christ. Jesus indwells us by his Spirit. It's our skin that those around us get to see outwardly, but our old man, the old man, we're supposed to crucify him. He's supposed to be gone, and now it's Christ that is living out his life in our skin. You've heard the phrase, saving your own skin or saving your own hide. Well, that's what's not quite what's happening here, but it's happening, but in a different sense. You and I say we want to save our skin, but when we use it, we're meaning we're trying to protect ourselves. God says, save your skin, but let me have it. Let God have it. You can have your life as God lives out his life through our skin. He's living through us. Think with me for a moment. Isn't the burnt offering exactly what Jesus was doing when he took on flesh and dwelt among us during his earthly ministry? He came to earth and surrendered himself to the will of the Father. He made himself of no reputation and gave his life in total surrender to the Father. You and I will become more powerful in our personal evangelism when we learn to die to self and let our God and Savior Jesus Christ live through our skin. Here in Leviticus chapter 1, verse 9, the one bringing the offering had to cut the animal in pieces, and then the worshiper had to wash all the inside parts. Now, that would have been a messy job. Well, you and I need to bring ourselves to worship before God, and while we're there, we need to examine ourselves and wash all the internal parts of our lives. We need to pray something like this: search me, O God, know my heart, try me and know my thoughts. Now, the heart and the thoughts, those are pretty internal stuff for us, spiritually speaking, amen? Try me and know my thoughts, see if there be any wicked way in me, and then I'm not going to fully quote out of the psalm there, but ending our prayer, and help me make things clean. Oh, my friend, no soul winner is a perfect Christian. Nobody's perfect but Jesus. But we need to be a burnt offering each day to our Savior. Amen? Oh, by the way, after the sacrifice was complete, it was the priest who got to keep the skin. Well, friend, after you and I worship God, we give our skin to our high priest, Jesus. He gets to live his life through our skin. That's what people ought to be seeing, Christ living in us. Amen? Now, friend, if you're listening today and you do not know Jesus Christ as Savior, you need a sacrifice, but not the burnt sacrifice. Before we get done, we're going to study the Passover. That's where the lamb was killed. His blood went into the Holy of Holies. The Passover lamb was a picture of Jesus coming to die on the cross. You need a Savior. You're a sinner. There's only one Redeemer. It's Christ. You need him. Receive him today as your Savior.
Thank you for joining us today for Bible Tract Echoes. If you would like to receive a free sample packet of our tracts, you can contact us by calling 309-828-6888. Our mailing address is Bible Tracts, P.O. Box 188, Bloomington, Illinois, 61702. Again, our phone number is 309-828-6888. And our mailing address is P.O. Box 188, Bloomington, Illinois, 61702. You can also contact us through our website. Our web address is BibleTractsInc.org. Remember, the word tracts is spelled T-R-A-C-T-S. That address is BibleTractsInc.org. May the Lord richly bless you as you serve him.